In this video, we will learn how to share files from Google Drive. First, we will talk about asking the recipient to make their own copy in their Google Drive so they could edit the file as they want. I have here one Google Slides. So I will go to share. I must choose anyone with this link and view. If you don't see it, just click change and it will be provided here. Okay, just click done. I will highlight the URL, Ctrl C. I will open another tab, Ctrl V. What I need to do is to remove the last part of the URL up to where you see edit, and then replace the last part with the word copy. Highlight it, Ctrl C, and you share that new URL or new link to anyone that you want to share the file. I have an email here, so I will do Ctrl V. And the person can use Ctrl click and open the file that I sent in the email. It will force the recipient to make their own copy of the file. When the person opens the file, he or she will notice that the word copy is at the beginning of the name of the file. Of course, the file could be renamed or it could be edited how the person wants to have this file in their Google Drive. Now, we will share the same file, but this time in presentation mode. I have here my Google Slides. I want to select some of the slides that I do not want to share. So I just do right click and I do skip a slide. Means the person won't be able to see this slide when they see my presentation. If I am ready to share, I will click the share button. Make sure it says anyone with this link can view. Then I will go to File, Publish to the Web. Click Publish. Okay. And you get a link here for this file. Ctrl C or copy. You can go to the email, do Ctrl V or paste, and you have the link. When the recipient click in this link, it will go directly to a presentation mode. I just clicking enter. If there is a video, it will show the video. Okay. If there is an image here, it will go to the image. If there is a link for a website, it will open the website in this file. So that's how you share your Google Slides file in presentation mode. Let's do the same process with a Google Doc file. In the share button, you make sure that it says anyone with this link can view. If I want to ask the recipient to make a copy, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, remove the word edit, and you just type copy. Okay. If they open the file, it will force them to make a copy. It will publish to the web this file. Okay. We will open a tab, Control-V, with a new link, and they can see a presentation version of the file. Let's do it one more time. So I have my file here. I click my share button. Anyone with this link can view. I do Control-C and I copy the URL. I open a new tab, Control-V or paste. I replace the last part that says edit with a word copy. If I click enter, means that I need to make a copy of the file and I will have this copy in my share drive or Google Drive. I will go back to the file. Okay. Now I will go to file, publish to the web, publish. Okay. I have a new link, Control-C for the presentation mode of this file, Control-V or paste. If I open the link, I can see the file, but in a presentation mode. I can see my chart with all my numbers, but there is also included a link for a website. So if I click here, you see I have access to the website. When we are trying to share the URLs, they are long URLs. So instead of that, we can use what is called short URL or hyperlink. In this email, I have the two long URLs that we already saw how we got them. So I will highlight the first one. Control-C. And then I will find what part of this sentence I want to use as a short URL, or maybe I want to use the whole thing. So let's say that I only want to say, click here. Okay. So I go to link or hyperlink, and where it says, click here, it will be associated to the long URL. Okay. So Control-V here, and I click OK. If the person click here, so he or she will have access to the link to make a copy of the file. I want to share in presentation mode, so I do the same. I highlighted my long URL. Control-C, but this time I want to use the words Viking Nation, that is the name of the file, to insert the link. So Control-V and click OK. So if I share just Viking Nation, okay, by clicking in this short URL, the person will be able to find the file in a presentation mode. Now, we will share the same file, but this time we will use a website called TinyURL. I have here my long URLs, so I will select one of them, Control-C. In the website called TinyURL, I will enter the long URL in the box that is here, Control-V, and I will make a tiny URL. Here, I have the URL that I can share, but it's called tiny URL, so Control-C. Instead to share the long URL, I just share the tiny URL. Can do the same. Control-C. Control B. And I have my new tiny URL. Click copy to the clipboard. And now I have a tiny URL for my other file. I have three options how to share my file. The long URL, the short URL, or the tiny URL. I need to choose one. When I send my email or I share the link in a Google Doc or in a Google Slide, or I want to post it in Facebook. If we want to share the file in Google Classroom, we will go first to the file, Control C, because I want to share the file in presentation mode. I will go to my Google Classroom. I can add an announcement in the stream section. This presentation is about Viking Nation, and I can add the URL by Control B here in the section of the message. I recommend that instead of that, you use the button for add a link. Control B, add the link, and then you post your message. And then the students get a preview of the file. Here is another example. Okay. I posted a tiny URL here, adding as a link. Or my Google Slides presentation after I publish to the web. So this is the URL. Or here, I added to the message the URL. And that's it. Thank you for watching.